a huge process to come up with a structure that is safe, efficient, and can be built really quickly.
It was a MasterChef activity going on.
The lights, the personnel, the size of the equipment.
Big heavy beams that we're talking about that can range from 100 tonnes to 120 tonnes.
The community has a great interest. We get to connect with them about leaving a legacy for them to enjoy.
It's really a great success story, the Albing. Probably about 5 years ago, LXRP realised that there was a huge opportunity with the number of crossings that we were going to be building elevated rail bridges for, to actually create a standardised structure. And there's been a number of projects that have iteratively continued to improve and innovate and then share those innovations across all of the other projects.
How can we do this more efficiently? How can we do this more cost effectively? How can we do this with less interruption to the public? There's the design process and the thought process of let's split a U-trough down the middle and take it and make it into two L-beams and have it delivered like that.
From an engineering perspective, you need to be adapting and innovating and developing your ideas. It's important we do consider everything, because if you don't, you can miss something that's really special that's just left to the side. So as many people as you can involved in innovation is absolutely essential to make it work.
U-trough starts its life at the precast yard, where two corresponding L-beams are cast in a casting bed.
We manufacture U-troughs every day. We plan to cast two beams every afternoon. The process involves removing beams from the mould in the morning, installing a reinforcement cage into the moulds through the morning, and then pouring concrete into the moulds in the afternoon.
And there's about 60 pre-tensioning strands that are in the L-beams, get pulled by about 18 tonnes of force and then held in position, and that helps to bring the L-beams up to their maximum strength.
We steam cure overnight and then we remove beams in the morning, so it's around a 12-hour process from start to finish. Each L-beam comprises of about 40 cubes of concrete and they weigh up to 110 tonnes.
The next step for the L-beam is to be ready for transport, be taken from the precast yard and delivered to site, and this requires a lot of planning.
Permits are issued by the National Heavy Vehicle Regulator. They're quite stringent and quite prescriptive. We actually had to get these L-beams on site at 11 p.m. Doing 140 kilometres, leaving at 9 p.m. meant that we weren't going to get these beams on site until post-midnight. So this created enormous problems. What we achieved with Vic Roads is approval for an early departure time from Kilmore. Dealing with Transurban, they actually granted us, for the first time, travel over the Balti Bridge and through the Burnley Tunnel. The journey time was significantly reduced.
Definitely the privilege of the tunnel has been a major asset to us, probably, as on fuel and, stopping and starting all the time, and, it's been good. Getting there safely is the main thing, because we're quite wide at the wheels and slow at times as the roads get slippery, obviously, and if we can break traction. We usually have one pilot at the front and then two at the back, because they'll cover the back end, and then the steerer will be directly behind me. And then we've got to unpin the trailer to get around a corner. We steer around the corner and then pin it back up, and then we get going again. It's a long process of getting to somewhere.
Once it's at the site, the L-beams need to be lifted onto the headstocks, and this is typically done with quite large cranes.
We had the really large traditional cranes that would lift some of them in some of the areas, but where we had a really narrow corridor, we actually used two rubber-tied gantry cranes, and we named them Kath and Kim. These have never been used in this context for construction anywhere in Australia.
We've demonstrated that this has been a really good standardised approach to removing these dangerous level crossings, and we're able to continue to share the learnings that we get from each of these projects to keep getting better and better at delivering these U-trough solutions.
I've taken my little kids over the top of the rail viaduct to the new stations. Baltimore, fantastic project, fantastic outcomes.
It was a really complex and challenging project because we had to shut the upfield line for 3 months and get in and build around about 2 kilometres of elevated rail structure and build two stations as well. The L-beam solution was the only way we could get that done.
Everything up until that point is it's all paper, it's all emails, phone calls, and then the day that it arrives, you're like, oh, it's here. Like, oh, it's like my present. My Christmas has come early.
Being on site for me was as exciting as being a 20-year-old when I was out at 4 o'clock in the morning dancing. But instead, at 4 o'clock in the morning, I've got a hard hat on, I've got my safety gear, and I was probably more excited.
And to see how good it looked, and it was awesome how, you know, they've finally come up in the end, yeah, it looked really good. And then you tell your kids, you know, that we built that bridge or whatever, yeah, it makes you feel good.
It's that sense of completing something and finishing it and actually achieving what you set out to do is really it.